Message, message to all of you, all organizers, Filipino friends, let's FMWU, Unisil, ano pa ba? Nagpapasalamat ako at pinasandok pa rin ang Sierra Hong Kong para makipag-organize sa Migrant March. And before we start, let's fight! Sigaw natin ang let's fight COVID! Unite with fight! COVID!
Vulnerability! Inequality! Discrimination!
I would like to specify those meaning of COVID. Actually, COVID is a virus everywhere in this society, you know. Especially migrants, domestic helpers. A lot of the struggles we are facing in employers' homes, you know. Overwork. Why we face the overwork? Because of the stay at home. Instead that our fellow migrants that are only preparing for dinner, but we face overwork because of staying at home for their employers and for employers' family members. Overwork because preparing for their breakfast, for their lunch, instead for only for dinner. And sometimes employers has a lot of visitors from their home, so para ma-additional ng mga trabaho ng ating mga fellow migrants. And vulnerability, hindi ko mabigkas-bigkas ang vulnerability eh. A lot of struggles na hinaharap ng ating mga kababayan, mga fellow migrants. Katulad na lang ng life stranded, a lot of fellow migrants who are stranded, termination. Because also the employers are facing also vulnerability. Kaya nag-terminate din sila ng kanilang domestic helper. Ayan po yung vulnerability na kinakaharap ng ating mga fellow migrants. And inequality. Why inequality? Because not only domestic helpers has the COVID. Because you know why? most employees ask their domestic workers to do not take their days off during Sunday and their holiday. But they advise or they ask to go to the market every day, you know. It's not only in the market that there's no COVID in the market or in the school. Only Sundays there is a COVID. Because they ask the domestic health workers not to take their day off. So this is inequality. And another example of inequality. When the domestic workers came from their day off, they want to spray them on alcohol from head to foot, you know? But their employers do not
take
proper hygiene. They were sleeping before bed, going to the bed. Like they don't go to the shower, to take shower, but the domestic workers, when they are going home from the day off, they have to clean them, you know? So that is an inequality. So a lot of virus case in this society. One more than discrimination, a lot also of discrimination that we are facing in this society, you know? Discrimination because the Hong Kong government also excluded us. The recent subsidy, government subsidy, like 10,000 Hong Kong dollars that they announced the low income in this society that received the 10,000 Hong Kong dollars. But we migrant workers are excluded. We are always excluded from this society. That is the discrimination. We need to fight. Let's fight and unite we fight. Mga kababayan. So kailangan natin mag-unite para to appeal our struggles in this society, to Hong Kong government and the Philippine government, that we are always excluded from the subsidy that we are going to accept also, that we are going to receive also, because we are also Hong Kongers, because we work also here. We help also to grow the economy. We spend our 10% of our income here in Hong Kong, you know. We don't send our 100% of our salary here in Hong Kong. We spend a lot of from our salary here in Hong Kong, but the Hong Kong government always excluded us from the subsidy, you know. We are the lowest income in this society, but we are always excluded. So we need also to build the inclusion, the social inclusion in this society. Thank you.
Yay!
Thank you very much. Jake, as Jake mentioned, we as migrant domestic workers are suffered from discrimination from the Hong Kong government. Being a domestic worker, we are always excluded with the aid or the financial support that given by the Hong Kong government. And since the time
ang pagpangon, ito na.